Hello everyone, my name is Jyoti Anchalkar and I will be your host today. Thank you for taking time out to attend today's webinar. I'm part of eBay Seller Education team, which is responsible for conducting webinars for training sellers like you about various eBay processes and best practices. These webinars are designed to help you grow your business and meet customer expectations. We hope that you will benefit from these webinars and apply the best practices in your business. Join our live webinars through the webinar calendar on export.ebay.com and get your questions answered in real time. The topic for today's webinar is account hygiene and customer service, which focuses on how seller levels and performance standards help you track your performance and let buyers shop with confidence. Our webinar agenda is as follows: understanding seller levels, factors impacting seller level and performance, seller standard criteria, becoming top-rated seller and benefits, issues with being below standard seller, service metrics and peer benchmarks, and the best practices. Let's have a look at the dashboard. Seller performance standards help you focus on what matters the most to your buyers. And in that way, it allows you to gain additional insights in your business. You can keep a track of your performance against the seller standards through the seller dashboard, which is available in your eBay account under Seller Hub, Performance tab. Under the Performance tab, simply click on the Seller Level tab, which is on the left-hand side, and you will be directed to the seller dashboard. On the screen, you can have a quick view on how exactly does your seller performance dashboard look like. We all know that to ensure a robust marketplace, sellers are evaluated on certain service performance metrics on eBay and are assigned standards. These standards help you track your performance and lets buyers shop with confidence. Based on factors such as dispatch time, customer service, and any issues with the transaction, you are assigned any of the three levels, which is eBay top rated seller, above standard, and below standard. Top rated seller means you are exceeding the set standards and are creating exceptional experiences for your buyers. Above standard means you are meeting the minimum standards that have been set and you have the potential to meet the top rated seller level. Below standard means you are someone who is falling below the minimum set standards and really needs to make changes to improve on the service provided by you. Now, sellers are evaluated and assigned either top rated seller or above standard seller or below seller standard level. Your performance is evaluated monthly, that is every 20th of the month. The length of time we look at in each evaluation depends on how many recent transactions you have had. If you have had 400 or more transactions in the last 3 months, you are evaluated over that 3 month period. If you have had fewer than 400 transactions in the last 3 months, then you are evaluated on the past 12 months. These timelines help us to make sure that we are evaluating you as fairly as possible. We track your account, how your account is actually performing on those things that matter the most to the buyer. These factors are transaction defect rate, cases closed without seller resolution, late shipment rate, and tracking uploaded and validated on time. Now, these are important factors that impact your seller level and your entire account performance. Let's go ahead and understand each of these a little bit in detail. Transaction defect rate. A defect is a transaction that's considered a bad shopping experience for a buyer. Your defect is affected by seller canceled orders, cases closed without seller resolution. To calculate your defect rate, we add your number of seller canceled orders and your cases closed without seller resolution, and then we divide that number by your account's number of total transactions for that given evaluation period. Cases closed without seller resolution counts again as an individual member. You can only have a certain amount of these before you drop in your seller standard rating. Late shipment rate, also known as on-time shipping performance. Your late shipment rate is the number of transactions that count as late shipments divided by the number of transactions for which we have shipping information. We track how often your item was shipped within the stated handling time or delivered to the buyer within the estimated delivery date. If there is tracking available, we will use that first. Remember, only transactions where shipping information is available are considered in your late shipment trade, that is tracking data from integrated carriers. If there is no tracking available, we will check with your buyer. If your buyer confirms that the item was delivered on time, you will be recognized for on-time shipping. Now, these three factors are the most important factors that decide on your seller level. The last factor that we are talking about, which is tracking uploaded and validated on time, this means that, first of all, this is applied only to eBay top-rated sellers. So this will be checked only if you are an eBay top-rated seller to ensure that your level is maintained. Now, what does this pertain to? It pertains to any orders for which tracking was never uploaded, was uploaded late, or did not have a valid scan. Now that we've understood what are the factors, let's look at what is the set criteria that eBay has set which you need to maintain to keep your level on the top. As you can see on the screen, we have the standard criteria, which are transaction defect rate, cases closed without seller resolution, late shipment rate, and tracking uploaded on time. Let's try to understand this with an example for above standard. In order to ensure that you stay above standard, you need to ensure that your transaction defect rate does not go beyond 2%. Similarly, your cases closed without seller resolution do not go beyond 0.30%. And your late shipment rate does not go beyond 7%. Anything that goes beyond the set criteria for above standard will make you fall under below standard. And anything that makes you improve on the set criteria of the above standard makes you go reach to another level, which is top rated seller, which means if your transaction defect rate happens to be between 0.50 or is even below that, there are chances that you may turn out to become an eBay top rated seller. Cases closed without seller resolution, again, maintaining it to 0.30. If your late shipment rate is 3% or even less than that, when you are evaluated, if all these three parameters are meeting as you see on the screen, yes, there are chances that you might become an eBay top rated seller. But you need to ensure that you meet the fourth criteria as well, which is tracking uploaded on time and validated has to be 95% and more. We did understand that if we do not meet the set criteria for above standard, you will fall under below standard. And if you fall under below standard, you will have to bear consequences. Although buyers cannot see that your seller level has fallen below standard, eBay will be reviewing your account and may place limits and restrictions on your account. There are a few consequences, not limited to, but may include for falling below standard, such as your items may be placed lower in search results. We may limit or restrict you from selling on your account and the related accounts as well, or from even registering a new account. Funds from your sales may be kept on hold. You'll be charged a higher percentage rate of 5% to 6% in final value fees. You will be blocked from using the advertising tool, that is the promoted listings tool, and will not be able to create new campaigns or even edit the existing campaigns. It's possible we may even downgrade your eBay store to a basic level if you have been a below standard for more than 60 days. And importantly, you would not be able to use the partial refund tool also. Remember, you can view your seller rating at any time in the performance sections under Seller Hub, and do make it a habit to check periodically to ensure that you're staying on track. Furthermore, you can also keep checking your CPT dashboard, that is your cross-border trade dashboard, to keep a track of the transactions that are possibly leading to bad buyer experience. Talking about becoming an eBay top-rated seller. Becoming an eBay top-rated seller indicates that you consistently deliver outstanding customer service. It also means that you are eligible to receive a prominent top-rated plus seal on qualifying listings. To become an eBay top-rated seller, you will need to have an eBay account that's been active for at least the last 90 days, have at least 100 transactions and $1,000 in sales with US buyers over the past 12 months. Comply with eBay's selling restrictions policy and meet the requirements of the transaction defect rate, cases closed without seller resolution, and the late shipment rate, along with tracking validation, as we discussed and did see in the earlier slide. If you have met these performance standard requirements on eBay.com, we will automatically upgrade you to an eBay top rated seller status in your next evaluation. As an eBay top rated seller, you can qualify for these exclusive top rated plus benefits if you offer same or one day business handling time and 30 days or longer free returns. What are the benefits? The top rated plus seal will be displayed prominently in search results and in the listing description, and a 10% discount on your standard final value fees. But please remember, this 10% discount on your standard final value fees is only available to sellers resident in the country in which they are top rated. We want to make sure that buyers have a great experience when shopping on eBay. So we try to help sellers provide great service for their buyers. We provide sellers with service metrics and peer benchmarks so that they can see how they are performing in comparison to other sellers who sell similar items. Your service metrics and your peer benchmarks help you keep track on how you are performing compared with others who sell similar items. You can monitor your service metrics and peer benchmarks on your service metrics dashboard in Seller Hub, which is a part of Performance tab. Service metric ratings and peer benchmarks. Your service metric ratings help you understand how well you are performing for item not as described return request and item not received return request in comparison to your peers. Your peer benchmarks show how you compare to other sellers with similar items, prices, shipping options, and terms of sale. Comparing your rate of item not as described return request and item not received request will give you a clear understanding on how well you are doing in these areas as compared to similar sellers. For item not as described return request, your peers are other sellers with a comparable volume of transactions who sell items in the same category as you with a similar price, item condition, return policy, and estimated delivery date. Now, service metrics include the information such as how often do you receive return requests for item not as described or item not received requests. Peer benchmarks and comparisons is what you receive. So comparisons of those rates to similar sellers. And you also get tips on how to reduce these requests. You also get insights into why your buyers are making these requests. Now, although service metrics may sound similar to the factors deciding your seller level, that there is a difference in both. Service metrics are peer benchmarks for item not received and significantly not as described cases, whereas seller performance level, your seller level is evaluated on transaction defect, cases closed without seller resolution, and late shipment rate. Service metrics is calculated for all cases opened by buyers for item not received and significantly not as described, as we call it as INR and SNAD returns, counted under service metrics. Whereas, under seller performance level, only cases closed without seller resolution are counted as defect. Please remember, when a buyer reports an issue to you, that is considered as a request. But if the buyer asks eBay to intervene or asks eBay to step in, that request becomes a case. So only those cases that were closed without seller resolution are counted as defects when we're evaluating you for your seller performance level. Service metrics, you are evaluated in the way as low, average, high, and very high. But seller performance level, you are assigned a standard. Below standard, above standard, and ETRS, that is Ebate operated seller. Please bear in mind that seller performance standards rating is not impacted by your SNAD or INR evaluation rate. Similar to your seller level, service metrics are also evaluated every month on the 20th of every month. Similar to your seller level, we take the number of transactions into considerations depending on the volume. So if your sales volume has been 400 or more than that, we will take the last 3 months for evaluating your service metrics. Whereas if fewer than 400 transactions, we will have a look back period or an evaluation period for the last 12 months. Your service metrics help you determine where to make improvements by leveraging aggregated data of sellers similar to you. For example, you can compare the reasons of your returns and identify ways to minimize returns. If you drive a higher than peer group service metrics, such as item not received, then it's time that you evaluate how you are shipping your items and what is the handling time that has been specified by you, etc. Your service metrics will reflect from low to average to high and very high. You need to remember, under service metrics, a low indicator means you're doing extremely good when it comes to providing a service to your buyer. You are performing better than most of your peers. You set and meet buyer expectations for item condition, careful packaging, and are ensuring orders are correct and complete before shipping. You are also meeting your handling commitments. You are uploading tracking when available and using the shipping services that are fast and that are fast or even faster than those what you have offered in your listing. Whereas a very high means you have terribly missed on meeting the buyer expectations. You are falling or rather failing to meet buyer expectations and delivery commitments at a rate that statistically stands apart from your peers and is making you fall down. Not meeting the service metrics in comparison to your peers can put you at a high risk of getting consequences for non-performance, such as the consequence guidelines are for items listed in categories that have been assessed as very high. For item not received rate, eBay will automatically add to the delivery estimates. Whereas for categories that you've been assessed as very high, for item not as described or a SNAD rate, there will be an additional of 5 or 4% depending on the region on which you have listed, whether it is USA, Canada, Canada French, Australia, UK, Italy, Spain, DE, that is Germany, or France. As you can see on the screen, for items shipped to addresses with high INR rate, if your listing region is USA, Canada, Canada, French, eBay will automatically add time to your delivery estimates, which will make the buyer take one step back before making that purchase because the delivery time is too much. Australia is now similar to what we read on the screen for USA, Canada, and Canada, French. For UK, Italy, and Spain, the consequences for item shipped to addresses with high INR rate is yet to be decided, but that doesn't mean that this does not lead to a bad buyer experience. So please ensure that you are aware of the policies for the bad buyer experience so that you can stay within control. For Germany and for France, we are yet to decide or rather announce the consequences for items shipped to addresses with high INR rate. Items in categories with high SNAD rate, of course, for USA, Canada, Canada, French, there will be an additional of 5% that is added to the final value fee. For Australia, UK, Italy, and Spain, as of now, it is 4%. For Germany also, it has changed, or rather now that it is for 4%. For France, as of now, there are no consequences. Again, Not having any consequences doesn't mean that you will falter or you will commit mistakes that will make you fall or fall under the consequence guidelines. Little details do matter, and special touches, especially for online transactions, can go a long way in making a positive impression, especially towards your buyer. There are several inexpensive, easy things you can do to create memorable shopping experience for your buyers and earn their loyalty, such as responding to buyers, shipping items on time, ensuring that you're managing inventory and keeping items well stocked to avoid cancellations, specifying reasonable shipping and handling cost, and also specifying the shipping and handling cost within the listing, describing the items accurately and including return policies. Avoiding selling products with high rates of manufacturing flaws, resolving customer issues even before they arise, being proactive in solving customer issues, following through on your return policy, ensuring all items and parts are included and are correct, working before you are shipping them to your buyers. Last but not the least, ensuring the item is delivered to the buyer as described in the listing. So that is all on today's webinar topic. We hope that the information shared today has been useful to you. Do keep joining us for our forthcoming training webinars. Keep checking the webinar calendar on export.ebay.com. Before we wrap up, make sure you hit that subscribe button on our YouTube channel. You will gain access to all our latest videos packed with tips and tricks to streamline your eBay selling experience. Don't miss out. The links are mentioned in the description. We will see you soon in the next webinar. Goodbye.